going on, I want to talk to y'all about this game real quick. Really good game. While I'm wrapping up some Lions content, man, had an opportunity to watch it while I was working. So, you know, tell of the halves with this team. Definitely tell of the halves. First half, no energy, lethargic out there. You know, just didn't look interested as they should have coming out of the gate. You know, tried to pick it up a little bit towards the end of the second quarter, and was able to pull that lead in a little bit. So, third quarter comes and the Pistons go full atomic. Full atomic, man. And it was, man, that was beautiful to watch, especially obviously the third quarter performance from Cade Cunningham, man. But just to see guys chipping in, and you know, like I said, man, to have him and Sadiq Bey plus 22, plus 27 out there on the court, man. You know, those type of stats right there. You wanted a 30-30. We definitely wanted a 30-30 for them too. But you know, K in the third quarter, you know, like I said, they sparked things off, knocked a few shots down, went inside out. Kelly knocked down two threes. Well, a two, three and a two. They deemed it a two. He stepped on the line. And then K comes right back and knocked down another one. And from right then, they never looked back. Never looked back. The shots just started falling, man. They finished this thing shooting 51% from three tonight as a team. So definitely got things going, man. You know, see some shots fall, and that's all that K needed. You know, started attacking the basket, wheeling and dealing, and do things like that. You know, like I said, Sadiq Bey was you know, silently and quietly doing this thing the whole time. And, you know, like I said, them two pulling together like that makes everybody else around him do much better, man. Killian took a little spill, but he's fine. Hit his back on the bottom of the rim, but he's good. Corey Joseph tonight was absolutely amazing. I tell you all the time, got to give credits when credit is due. He was absolutely amazing tonight, man. He was 5-for-8 from three-point land tonight. And you notice, for instance, with Cade Cunningham, when Cade decides to hunker down and take shots and be aggressive and be that polarizing guy that we know he can be, it makes everybody else around him better. Guys were able to actually sit in the corner. I know y'all might hear my kids in the background. But guys were able to sit in those corners and be ready to shoot simply because they was running that high screening and roll with him and Lyles. Probably the reason why you didn't see Stu get back in the game because of what Whiteside was doing to Stu by just standing back and forcing Stu to take the shot, which is, you know, obviously something that he's regressed in because he doesn't look confident to take it. Last season, he was letting him fly with no hesitation. This season, it's a little bit more of an afterthought. So because of that, they had Lyles in the game, and you know, simple basketball. Ain't this what I was talking about? You know what I'm saying? Give Kane the ball. Everybody move out. Bring me up a screen. Let me work. Simple. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, it worked so well in the second half because these are the type of guards that we have. We have guards that can get there. Kane can get his own, but Kane, you know, is also a pick and roll type of guy. Pick and roll is the best thing for him to have success, man. It really is. Because like I said, right now, standing at the top of the, you know, key and did, making some dribble moves and taking a bunch of step back threes, that's not gonna win this Pistons team a lot of games. But when they're running that screen and roll with him, obviously we got Bobo coming. It opens up everything for everybody. You know what I'm saying? Guys are able to get those open shots, man. You look at some of the things they was doing when Killian was out there, wide open. You know, man felt comfortable biting. And it's like I said, we all know what this thing is. It's not that he can't hit the shots, it's taking them for him. So if you leave him that wide open, he's going to probably knock it down. You know what I'm saying? So, but K was able to wheel and deal, man, and dish, you know, when it wasn't there, even though a couple of turnovers came. You know, it is what it is. Those are going to be there. But, you know, he had five turnovers, but, you know, at the same time, he made up for it with his play, especially in third quarter. He started it, Our backcourt started it, and Headband Deke finished it. You know, they both finished with 29, but Sadiq finished it, man. Sadiq shot the ball really well tonight. 5-for-7 from three-point line, 10-for-14 overall, 4-for-4 from free throw line. Also, you know, the notable thing is Cade with 8 assists, and that speaks to what I was just telling you guys about him being able to wheel and deal out there and have guys ready and set to shoot and get good shots. That's one of our biggest problems over the season is getting good shots. A lot of passing up on wide open shots, then, you know, having that afterthought and pump faking and you know, putting yourself in a bad situation. That's been a thing with this young team. But tonight, those guys was ready. Corey Joseph didn't have that role of holding the basketball and doing something retarded out there. Corey Joseph played tonight like what he was supposed to play when we brung him here. You know, when Kay steps into that leadership role, everything else is going to work fine. Guys won't be out of position. We play so many guys out of position and out of their you know, their own characteristic, you know, what they're comfortable with. You know what I'm saying? So it's like with this situation, guys were comfortable out there. And he just did his thing, took his time. Like I said, man, pick him apart. I'm a shoot this three. If you step back too far and if you come up, I'm gone. You know what I'm saying? So, and if it ain't there, I'm looking for somebody else. You know, pick and roll. You know what I'm saying? They got the option with Lyles to pick and pop. Even though he's undersized, man, he can shoot the three. So, definitely going to have that option with Bobo. Bobo can shoot the hell out of the ball from three-point land. So, you know, it's definitely going to be interesting when Bobo get here, man. It's definitely going to be very interesting because he has a true legit chance within these next 40-plus games to show if he's worthy of some type of extension or something from the Pistons. They got a good take of it. You know, he's a restricted free agent after the season. So, you know, I'm trying to cram everything in right. It's so much, man. You know what I'm saying? When I watched the game, I had an imaginary little bowl out there. You know what I'm saying? Putting him in this situation, that situation. We would have been able to block that shot, or he would have been able to get the rebound and, you know, anything. And that's how I watched the game. But, you know, like I said, collective effort from this team in the second half, man. First half just wasn't there, but the second half, everybody rallied around them guys, man, and they took care of business, and the Pistons come out with a victory, 126-116, versus a Utah Jazz team without Rudy Gobert. So we don't worry about that because we without a lot of firepower in Frank Jackson, Jeremy Grant, and Olynyk. So that type of stuff don't matter for me in these wins, but we're knocking on the door for 10 wins finally. And the Pistons in 2022 have been a much better team. They've been a much better team, man. And it's only going to get better the healthier they get. The healthier they get, and with Troy Weaver making solid moves like he is, man, it's going to get better. So it feels good to say that, man, because from the very beginning, I know some of y'all drowned me out when I kept saying, let's just be patient. Let these guys, you know, play this full season throughout, man. Get that learning experience. Like I said, it helps when you got some veterans like some of these other rookies got and second-year players got. But, you know, the Pistons, yeah, ours is out right now. We don't really have that presence. But these guys, they are learning on the fly. So we got to allow them an opportunity to do that, man. And like I said, 51%. Season high, I believe, 19 three-pointers tonight. 19 for 37 tonight from three-point land. That's a season high for the Pistons. And like I said, 91% from the free throw line, 50% from the floor. So they definitely picked it up, man, after a subpar start to the game. And, you know, hey, if we start games and come on late, then I'd rather have that than start games hot and then you know, diminish in the third and fourth quarter. I want game end to end, but if I gotta pick one, I'll pick this style anytime. So, you know, with that said, man, I hope you guys enjoyed the game. Like I said, we just gotta be patient, man. Let these young guys get more and more reps and more games under their belts. I know some of us, we want to see some of these players put in different situations. For instance, with Killian Hayes, you know, some of us, including myself, would say, hey, if he's struggling to do this or if he's not doing what you want him to do, then put him on the bench. Put him on the bench and let him get the second unit rolling and, you know, do what he got to do out there. But as the season progresses, we'll see what happens with that situation. Obviously, I still feel Cade is not a point guard. He's a guard that can pass. But that's probably the only reason why Killian is sticking there in that starting position. It's got to be because your staff is not asking strictly for the scoring. But tonight, I want to make this known, something that I don't see Casey do. The assistant coach tonight, you can hear him through the TV tonight. It was that less people in there. You can hear him through the TV tonight, and he was telling them to clear out and move out of the way just so Killian could attack the basket. And even though on two of them he didn't make it, coach told him to do it. I like that a lot. I wish Dwayne Casey would do that more. Our biggest thing is we don't care if you miss it. We want you to take it. How do we know what you can do if you don't do it? And that is the biggest thing with Killian Hayes with a lot of us, man. That's why we say him coming off the bench is probably the best thing that should have happened from the beginning, because when he was drafted, it was said that he would take some time to develop offensive game. But I think they get a little too comfortable with the defense, because the defense, again, was on display tonight. And they keep him out there in that situation. And to me, it's not helpful for him no more. It never was. It never should have been. But it's not helpful because, like I said, if this is what you truly want, you got to push that narrative. Hey, you know what? Okay, let's put you on the bench and let you come with the second unit. And, you know, we can work on attacking the basket or whatever the third. So, like I said, they're starting him this amount of games and consistently. It says to me that, you know, that's not to say all be all of what they asked him to do out there. But it's something that us fans, we would love to see. Because, you know, he's a bigger guard. So you got to attack the basket when it's allowed. I think Bol Bol is going to help a lot in that situation, to be honest, though. Because a lot of times when Killian attacks the basket, it's somewhere there to meet him every time. Every time you attack the basket, someone's there to meet him. So with Bol Bol being that roll and lob threat option, ladies and gentlemen, believe me when I say this. If Bol Bol comes and does what Bol Bol does, and we don't run into some hiccups, it's going to help Cade and Killian tremendously. Tremendously, because we all know we need that pick and roll guy that is a lob threat, and also he's a pick and pop threat. That's the other thing. He's a pick and pop threat. He literally is what we needed. So if this, you know, everybody know he's talented. Yeah, he fell to the second round, but that was because of the foot injury in Oregon. But we all know he's talented. You know, for us that watch other teams or keep up with other teams, we all know. You know, just you see these other fan bases talking about it. They know. They were upset that we got him and they didn't. So this guy was a guy that was supposed to be a top five prospect, man. And he's just been sitting in Denver, you know, behind somebody, which you can't argue with. Obviously, he's a joker. So he got his opportunity. He's being brought here to have an opportunity because he's going to be on the floor. He's going to be on the floor. So, like I said, man, let's just give this thing some time. We got a whole other half a season to worry about. So, you know, these type of performances right here, they're a good scratch on the back for a lot of us content creators that's been preaching a patient route for you guys. But, yeah, 29 from Cade and Sadiq Bey tonight, man. Excellent performances. Corey Joseph, 16 points. Trey Lyles, 14. And Josh, 11, man. So, overall, really good game. Tail of the halves. And the Pistons was able to finish. You know, Sadiq Bey just said that in his press conference before the game, that they finished that game against Orlando. And hopefully they can do it the rest of the way. Well, tonight is a stepping stone to do that. So, congratulations, young fellas, man. And on to our next game. I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow. Peace.